Alright, so there's a guard over there. He's mad at me for being up here. I'm not allowed to be up on the rooftops. So we could deal with him. Or we could just ignore him. I'm totally not here, bro. Totally not here. I don't really feel like killing him. He's just an innocent guard, just doing his job. So we're gonna leave him be. But we are gonna go to our objective. He can't hear me. He's dumb. Sometimes they can actually see out of the back of their head, something they improved on greatly in later games. But in this one, there's a bit of a problem with that. We're gonna stay up here. Okay, I guess we're not. Oh, we probably... No, we don't need to do Eagle Vision. There we go. Just had to wait for him to show up.
The numbers change nothing. Your men have failed to fill the order, which means I have failed my client.
We need more time.
This is the excuse of a lazy or incompetent man. Which are you?
Neither.
Both.
What I see says otherwise. Now, tell me, what do you intend to do to solve this problem of ours? These weapons are needed now.
I see no solution. The men work day and night, but your client requires so much, and the destination. It is a difficult route.
Would that you could produce weapons with the same skill as you produce excuses.
I have done all I can.
It is not enough.
Then perhaps you ask too much.
Too much? I gave you everything. Without me, you would still be charming serpents for coin. All I ask in return was you fill the orders I bring you. And you say I ask too much?
Oh.
You dare disrespect me?
Peace, Tamir. I meant no insult.
Then you should have kept your mouth shut.
No, stop.
Stop? I'm just getting started.
This is an illustration of an unambiguous assassination target.
You came into my souk, stood before my men, and dared to insult me?
Sometimes you won't be sure why you're gonna assassinate someone. With this guy, it's pretty fucking obvious.
Leave the body. Let this be a lesson to the rest of you. Think twice before you tell me something cannot be done. Now get back to work.
I'm gonna get back to work. I like my job. No coins for you, lady. I can't actually get... Oh. We're being a little suspicious for some reason. I think it's because this lady's all over our jock. So, this guy... Where'd he go? I don't know where he went, but he's going to be cruising around. There we go, we're not suspicious anymore. No, nothing. Let's get away from that lady. He'll be cruising around here, and our job is to kill him. Not without people finding out, just to kill him. And one of my preferred ways to do that is death from above. Crabbing ledges appears to be a problem for Altair. There we go. Oh, it's because he couldn't drag himself up because of that one spot. Alrighty. No harm, no foul. Now we got to find our target. He is possibly right below us. Nope, he's somewhere in here.
I don't understand what you do all day. Your stall is filled with goods. It should be your purse that's filled with coin.
Where is this guy?
It isn't difficult.
I can hear him.
Perhaps you are not trying hard enough.
Just a little money, I beg of you.
Dude?
You require motivation.
Oh, I know where he is. There he is. Oops. Uh-oh. Wrong one. So we're gonna wait up here for him. and look like a roof-climbing scholar.
No, you don't understand. I have nothing.
Maybe we should just... Nah, we'll just get down.
Where did you learn your craft?
So yeah, we're gonna go and give this guy a good greeting.
No, you don't understand. I have...
Hi.
Be at peace. You'll pay for this.
Maybe.
You and all your kind.
It seems you're the one pays now, my friend. You'll not profit from suffering any longer.
You think me some petty death dealer, suckling at the breast of war?
Mm-hmm.
A strange target, don't you think?
Mm-mm.
Why me, when so many others do the same?
You're a dick.
You believe yourself different, then.
Oh, but I am. For I serve a far nobler cause than mere profit. Just like my brothers.
Brothers?
Ah. But he thinks I act alone.
Mm-hmm.
I am but a piece. A man with a part to play. You'll come to know the others soon enough. They won't take kindly to what you've done.
Good. I look forward to ending their lives as well.
Such oh, I'll tear.
It will destroy you, child.
Thanks, Dad. We had a little blood sample for the crime scene, guys. And now we need to run like fucking hell. Yeah. Alright, bye. No touchy. Don't touch me. I have herp AIDS. Yes, I will. This is not a good hiding spot up on top of this thing. There's that guard we didn't kill. But, easy enough. Okay. I was like, are you gonna fucking get in there, bro? Now we just give it a little wait, and then we can cruise our way over to the Bureau and report our good work. Didn't have to kill anybody unnecessarily. Just got our one guy. And, yeah, I'll continue this and I'll check the sound after we head back to the Bureau. Fortunately for this part, there aren't a lot of guards up on the rooftops. There will be later. That changes as the game goes on. But for right now, we're pretty much free to go roof cruising however we please. But that scene with him talking to the guy he's just stabbed, I like it, but I never really understood it. I mean, I guess it doesn't make sense in a literal kind of way, but that'll happen every time he kills someone. There will be sort of like a post-critical blow interview, I guess, which is very strange, but good for getting a little extra information.
Word has reached me of your victory, Altair.
Yeah, the bells.
You have my gratitude and my respect.
Thank you.
It is a shame that the other assassins continue to hold you in such poor regard.
Rafik, I do not care what the others think of me.
As you wish, Altair. You should bring news of your victory to Al-Mualim.
Mm-hmm.
I'm certain he has more work for you to do.
Oh, of that I have no doubt.
To a more recent one.
So, this is one of my favorite parts. Return to Al-Mualim. Oh no, we have to get back on our horse and ride the crazy train. No. Sometimes it'll ask you if you want to return or if you want to stay. In this case, you just go. Because you're not actually going
out
to see Al-Mualim.
Out of the machine, Mr. Miles?
Yes, Dad.
What's the matter, Doc?
Miss Stillman is once again insisting I let you rest.
She likes me. Thanks, lady. You want to talk about it? I think you'd like me. She's waiting for him to leave. You have a crazy cool pen. Look at that thing. It's all flashy. Cool pen.
So, feel like telling me who put the stick up his ass?
We have a deadline. 1 week. Well, 6 days now.
Deadline?
I can't talk about it.
Man, put yourself in my shoes. I'm being held hostage by a group of scientists. At least I think you're scientists. And forced to spend all day in some crazy-ass machine. You won't tell me what you're looking for or why you want it, but I'm supposed to be thanking you for keeping me alive. This is so fucked. Sorry, but it is.
What do you want me to do?
Let me go?
Let's see. I don't know. Maybe give me some answers?
I can't. And it's better this way. Safer.
Safer for who?
Both of us.
Really? Well, that's interesting.
What's up?
Why is it that sometimes the guys in there talk like they're from the future?
The future?
I mean the present. Now, today, whatever.
You've probably noticed that English has become the official language of the Holy Land.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
The Animus is translating speech it deems vital into more modern English, so expect a few anachronisms. I could probably make it more authentic, but... You ever read Chaucer?
Who?
Geoffrey. Two Fs.
Yeah, definitely not for you.
Actually, I don't think he had any Fs. It might have been with a PH.
Can you tell me more about Abstergo? What goes on here?
This is Abstergo, isn't it?
Keeping me prisoner thing.
It is.
Abstergo is one of the largest pharmaceutical companies in the world. Their primary focus is antidepressants. There's some information on the computer over there.
But you already said this isn't about testing a drug. So what's the deal?
I don't like where this is going.
So it's safe to assume the Animus is not a part of their public face.
What, you haven't seen the commercials?
Oh my god. She has a sense of humor.
I'm sorry, Desmond. I've got a lot of work to do. Like I said, if you want to know more about the company, take a look at the computer.
Can I check
my... telecommunication stuff is particularly interesting.
Can I check my Facebook page? So that was a bit odd. About the telecommunication stuff, eh? So the only thing you can do on here is check her email. So this is about Layla, between her and Warren Vidic. You said wind up like Layla earlier. What did you mean? Nothing. Get back to work. We have a deadline. Why do you sign your emails? It says right up top who it's coming from. Yeah, we don't really know what happened to Layla. This is a general bit of slightly classified information about Abstergo. It's just basically a please don't tell anyone about our stuff or we'll fucking kill you kind of thing. Thank you for your compliance, citizen. So Lucy found Warren's access key pen. That pen is not just a cool pen. It is a cool pen, but it's also an access key. Left it hanging off of his coat. He's just leaving it around. They'd have to shut us down for at least a day to reprogram the computer. Leave it at my desk. Worry less about the things and more about making Animus work. Thanks. So Vidic lost his pen. And she left it at his desk. But it's not here right now. But, you know, a little bit more information for us. He's got a message. It's flashing.
Aren't you tired?
No. I had coffee. Are you tired? That's a sign that she has no more to say to us. Until we go have napski. Nap time. And all we can really do here is go and take the nap. No.
Let's go, Mr. Miles. Time's wasting.
At least you're not standing over me. Touching me this time. You freaky weirdo. What's on the schedule for today? Do I get to murder more people?
Oh, don't worry. She'll be with us soon enough.
So why are you doing all this, Doc?
Yeah, jerk.
What are you hoping to accomplish?
You turn the television on lately? Read the newspaper?
Never cared much for that stuff.
Then let me sum it up for you. The world's a mess. It's pathetic, really. You've seen it firsthand yourself. 1,000 years between you and your ancestor, and society remains just as barbaric, just as stupid.
And your point is...
It's a little less barbaric, actually.
Order, Mr. Miles. The world needs order. That is what we're working towards, and that is what you're helping us to achieve.
It's pretty orderly to me.
You expect me to believe you're building a better tomorrow?
That's exactly what we're doing. The human race calls out for direction. They want to know why they're here, what they're meant to do. Well,
make babies?
We're going to tell them.
Babies.
And once they understand how to live their lives,
babies,
everything will be better.
Babies.
Better how?
Babies.
An end to all conflicts, large and small.
Babies.
Isn't that what you assassins strive for?
No, babies.
Peace in all things.
Peace in all things. And babies!
I told you, I'm not an assassin.
Actually...
Right.
I still don't see where I fit into things.
He said he was.
In time, Mr. Miles. In time, you'll understand. Or you won't. I don't care either way, as long as you show us where it is.
Where what is?
Sorry, I'm late. Ready to go?
Yes, we are.
Interesting little bit there where he says again that he's not an assassin, even though earlier in the game you heard him say, I'm not an assassin, or at least not anymore. So, in a way, he's kind of delusional. What you working on? Making a blog post?
Lie down, dammit!
Oh, Jesus. Why can't I have a girlfriend like that? Let's get this over with! And we're on to memory block 3. No data. Let's make data.
Use the scholars you have rescued to pass unnoticed into guarded areas.
The computer apparently doesn't know that I don't rescue scholars.
You've done well, Altair. And I'm confident that this is but the first of many successes.
Tamir spoke as if he knew you well. He implied my work had a larger meaning.
Significance comes not from a single act, but the context within which it is performed. The consequences born of it.
Then is there more I need to know?
Altair, your greatest failure was born of knowing too much. Mm. If I choose to withhold information, it is only to ensure you do not make the same mistake a second time.
Control.
I see.
No, you don't. And it will remain this way until you've learned your lesson. Still, you have performed competently, and as such, I restore a rank and will return a piece of your equipment.
My knife!
Go now, either to Acca or Jerusalem. There are men in both cities who require your attention. The bureau leaders can tell you more about what needs to be done.
Goody. So we can go to either Acca or Jerusalem. And we've got a knife! It's somewhere on my back. I'm not sure exactly where, but it's back there somewhere. And we got counter kill back, which is the second most important one after ledge grab, of course. Let's go use it. Punch some people in the face.
Altair, it seems my students do not fully understand what it is to wield the blade. Perhaps you could show them what you know.
Pointy end, other man, still. Basically for this one, you just hold the right trigger, and then attack while they're attacking. And kick them in the nuts. Perfect. This guy's got a few more nut kicks coming his way, too. He's gonna have a bad day. Oh, nut punch.
The work of a master.
Oh.
That, my students, is how we all should
that
fight.
Guy is never gonna have kids. They're fucking practicing and they're calling each other infidels.
You must be busy.
They're really getting into character for their role-playing. Alright, so later, when we leave on an assassination mission, at this point, it'll give us an option to fast travel to it. But we have to discover the cities first. So we need to go to Jerusalem or Acre, I think he said? I don't remember. We already went to Dumbass. I didn't nearly kill you. I just fucking ran into you. That guy's such a pansy. But it's good to know that we've got some of our good abilities back. And that's really what we're doing here, is we're regaining our abilities and our stature. And hopefully gaining a little bit of wisdom along the way. And I missed. Because I'm a derp. And I missed again, because I'm a derp.
Can someone tell me why he's doing that?
Because it's fucking awesome. Oh my goodness. Not that strange. Okay, that was a bit strange. Pay no mind. I'm sure everybody does this. We're assassins, you know? Tyrizzo! He's got skinny legs. You fucking hipster horse. So, I may... Didn't even see that guy until he was screaming in agony. I may skip some of these horse travel sections, because some of them can be pretty long, and it's basically just, you know, The same thing you already saw. Again, one of the reasons that the game received criticism for this aspect of it is that it's pretty redundant and unnecessary to the point where they even made it completely redundant by adding that little fast travel feature later on. But for this portion, we do need to go to where we're going. I'll do one more horse ride. I'll have to decide whether we want to go to Jerusalem or to Acre.